In this lecture, we study about relational operators. Here, we see a list of relational operators, also called as comparison operators. They relate or compare two values. We have less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, and not equal to. Let's take few examples. So suppose we write A greater than B. This expression will either evaluate to value true or will evaluate to value false depending upon whether A is greater than B or not. Now suppose I write A less than or equal to B. So this means this expression will be true when either A is less than B or A is equal to B. So let's take different cases. Suppose we have A is equal to 10. And B is equal to 20. A is less than B in this case, and therefore this expression A less than equal to B will return value true. Suppose I have A is equal to 10 and B is also equal to 10. In this case, A is equal to B, and therefore this expression would again give me a value as true. So what we see is either A has to be less than B or A has to be equal to B for this expression to return a value true. Otherwise, let's say if I have A equal to 20 and B equal to 10. Now here A is neither less than B nor A is equal to B. In such a case, the expression will return a value false. For checking the two values for equality, we write A equal equal to B. So here, suppose A is 10 and B is 10. So that is the time when this equation will become 10 equal equal to B and this will return a value true. In all the other cases, this will return value false. That is, when value of A and B are different, this expression returns a value false. And similarly, I can check for two things to be not equal. So here now if I take the same case, A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 10, then in that case this will become 10 not equal to 10 and this statement is false. So this expression will return a value false. Expressions that evaluate to Boolean value, that is either true or false, are called as Boolean expressions. Using relational operators, we can form such expressions. So suppose I write now A greater than B. We have just seen it in the previous slide that this either returns a value true or false. And thus such an expression that I have formed using relational operator is called as a Boolean expression. Using relational operators, we can compare strings also. Let's take this first example. We are comparing A greater than M. Now how this is compared and what is going to be the value of such an expression? For this, we must understand that in our computer system, every character is represented by some number using an encoding scheme. Python uses Unicode encoding scheme. So using Unicode encoding scheme, character A is encoded as 65. Okay. Character B is encoded as the next number, that is 66, and so on. So character M is encoded as 77, and then you can go up to character Z, which is encoded as 90. So what we see here is that when I compare A greater than M, then character A is known as 65 to the computer system. So this expression becomes 65 greater than. Now character M is known as 77 to the computer system. So now this becomes a numeric comparison and we can immediately see that this expression will evaluate to value false. Now let's come here and see what will happen in such a case. Okay, A greater than A, but here A is in capital and here A is in small. Please understand that both capital and small are treated differently by our computer system. Okay, so small a is also going to have an encoding. This encoding will be starts from 97, then we have small b which is 98 and so on. Okay, so that means that capital alphabet A is encoded as 65 and small alphabet A is encoded at 97. So this expression becomes 65 greater than 97. Again, we can immediately see the statement is false. So now the idea is not to memorize all these numbers. Okay, you can broadly understand that capital A is 65 and then calculate the rest. Similarly, you can remember that A is 97. Now, you also can remember it like this, that capital alphabet will have lesser Unicode encoding as compared to small alphabet. Okay, so now let's look at the third case here, third example. So we have apple less than mango. What will happen here is the comparison will happen character by character. So first character A will be compared with M. First character A will have encoding 65 and this has encoding 77. So 65 less than 77, this value will be, or this expression will evaluate to true. Again, how do I remember the encoding of each one? No need to do that. You can just understand that this capital A is capital here, M is capital here, and understand that capital A comes before M. Therefore, encoding of A will have a value lesser than encoding of M. That much, if you remember, it is sufficient. Now let's come here. We have now this word is also starting with A and this word is also starting with A. So now how the comparison will be? So we have capital A, capital A, both have the same value. Next we go to the next character, that is P and P. Again, they are also same. So small p and small p, they are also same. Okay, so we go to the third one. Now here we have small p and small r. So you can understand, no need to remember what is the encoding. You understand that you'll have first p and then you'll have r. So that means encoding of p, the number associated with p will be lesser than number associated with r. Okay, so whatever that number is. So we can say that small p is less than r and we are comparing it for the greater than sign. And therefore this expression will evaluate to false. Okay, now here we see when we do the comparison. So we see that A is same as A, P is same as P, and the third P is also same as P. Okay, and then we have nothing more to compare. In such a case, you have to take that string which has length greater as to be having the greater Unicode value. Okay, so this will be apple will be greater than app because length of apple is larger than app, and therefore this will return a value true. Okay, now let's look at this example here where we have 10 greater than 2. So immediately if I look at this expression, I would understand that this is going to return me value true. Okay, so let's see what will happen. Please understand that 10 is enclosed in single quote. 2 is also enclosed in single quote. What this means is that 10 is not a numeric value here. 10 is a string. 2 is also a string. So these numbers that you see, they will also have encoding associated with them. Each digit here. So let's look at the Unicode encoding. We have 0. 0 has Unicode encoding of 48. Okay, this is not O but 0. Then we have 1, that would be 49 and so on. Okay, so now if you look at now the comparison, then 1 will be compared with 2. Okay, 1 getting compared with 2 means it's Unicode encoding getting compared. So 1 is 49 and 2 is going to be 50. So this comparison becomes now 49 greater than 50, which is false. So therefore this expression returns a value false. Let's look at the precedence of relational operators as compared to arithmetic operators. Remember, relational operators have lower precedence over arithmetic operators. So let's take an example of an expression where we have both the operators. So let's write A plus B greater than C plus D. In this expression, you see there is an arithmetic operator also and there is a relational operator. As per this table, okay, you would observe that all the arithmetic operators have higher precedence over the relational operators. Thus, first arithmetic operator will be involved, will be evaluated. So A plus B will be evaluated. Let's say this gives some result R1, and C plus D will be evaluated. Let's assume that this gives some result R2. After that, the statement becomes R1 greater than R2, which is going to evaluate to value true or false.